Welcome to you all. I'm Martin Tyler. Alan Smith is with me. As always, we'll try not to make any slips in the commentary, but there might be some slips out on the pitch, Alan, in these wet conditions.
Yeah, and I don't think it's going to stop during the course of the match, so I don't think it's going to affect the game in any way in terms of calling it off, but it might get very wet for the players.
Check now on the team players for Sassuolo today. Well, it's pretty fashionable these days, isn't it? The 4-3-3 gives you the three in midfield, which managers like to.
And he scores with the header!
What a header it was. But it's flown over the top of the keeper.
So the first goal, it's 1-0.
Goal news now from Verona.
It's a goal from Napoli. It's been scored by a lot.
And shoots!
Oh, it's over the top. See what footwear the teams are going to actually use today now that this rain is coming down. Might have to change what they originally started with.
Yeah, and I think sometimes with the lads wearing blades these days, you do see them slipping a bit more. And it might mean they have to change halfway through this match.
There's Cilio. Alan McAnally was telling us about that Napoli goal. And we had to cut him short. I can confirm Napoli have scored. And that's the first goal.
And onto the Mate,
and it's in for the equaliser.
And that has just lasered into the corner. Unstoppable.
It is level. Both sides have scored here now. Alan McAnally wants to join us now. He's got a goal to tell us about.
It's a goal for Fiorentina. 10 minutes played, 1-0.
Thank you very much, Alan. Kuchka. Nunez.
He's got room to hit this. He's kept it out.
It's a free kick and that's all it is. The referee is keeping his cards in his pocket. Throw to come up now after the ball's gone out. Francesco Acerbi.
He's going to cross it. Oh, great work by the keeper.
And it's out for a corner.
Shut off now, and the goalkeeper plunged to make the save.
It's a poor touch and the possession's gone away. Adeli. And the defender has dispossessed him. Cilio. Bonaventura. And the slide tackle very successfully done. Goal news from Juventus.
It's a goal for Juventus. 27 minutes, please. 1-0.
Interesting news again from Alan McAnally. Thanks, Alan. Well, they're good at corners. Let's see what this one brings.
The shot's on. He's just reached it, the goalkeeper.
They can't get it away. Corner again.
Shot's on.
Well, he's had a go.
Well, if you don't buy a ticket, as they say, and fair play to him for having a crack.
Well,
lost possession here. Play on, says the referee.
It will be fair throw.
Kuchka. Bonaventura. And the ball's gone again. Goal news from the Stadio Olimpico, Alan McAnally.
It's a goal for Roma. 39 minutes played. 1-0.
Isco! Oh, it's the post!
Well, you have to play it the way you're facing sometimes, even if you're facing your goalkeeper all that distance away. He slid in for the tackle. It was a bit of a cut-off for Alan McAnally, wasn't it? But I'm sure you got the point. Roma have scored. And that's the first goal of the game. It's 1-0. And that's a very successful slide tackle. Ante. Well, only two more minutes to be added on by the referee now. That's a useful ball in. Blown for half time at 1-1. Well, the player that we're featuring here has done well. And here we go with the start of the second half. And he's moved in, trying to jostle the opponent off his stride. Kuchka. Badelli. It's looking good, this move. Excellent passing. Great interplay.
It could be a chance. That's even better play to stop the chance.
And Milan have now a free kick.
That's good play.
Get the ball rolling again. Francesco Acerbi. Time for the substitutes, I think, and the substitution for the home team here.
Very good tackle. It's a quick break. Menez! Oh, a good goal, and now they're a goal to the good.
He didn't need any power, really, just enough to roll it past the goalkeeper because the placement was so good.
I think you've got to be playing with an awful lot of confidence to try that, and he is.
Off we go again, 2-1. Giving the opposition a problem with their interpassing. Badelli. On the attack here. Brilliant football from this team. Nice bit of interplay between these two. Going to be a substitution here for the home side.
Oh, lost possession here.
Goal news now from Verona.
It's a second goal for Napoli. It's been scored by Lorenzo Insigne. That's his second today. The keeper probably didn't see this till late. A low, hard shot from distance, through a crowd of players, buried into the back of the goal. 60 minutes played, 2-0.
Oh, interesting news again from Alan McAnally. Thanks, Alan. Very good intercepting play there to get his positional situation right and win the ball without too much effort. And you'll be able to see on EA Sports this Serie A fixture involving the hosts. Ignazio Abate.
This might be it! Wonderful save! Had to really reach out for that.
He can only put it behind for the corner. Well, he he's not managed it this time, but having scored in the game, I'm sure he'll keep on trying.
Well, he should do, because he's had a decent game out there, and his confidence should be high after that earlier goal.
And he passes back to the keeper. Milan, their next game, Alan?
Well, they're playing Chievo in the next match in Serie A, and I don't think they'll find too many obstacles in the way.
This could be a chance. The shot's up! Up for grabs here. Him there to running the ball out of play. Well, now they're behind, they've got to try and switch things around, and here comes a substitution. Well, that's a good challenge between the two of them there. The keeper can collect this one. Keep an eye on the watch, because we haven't got that long to go. And the team know that. They can't get too desperate, though. They need to keep some sort of poise about their play.
Yeah, they've got to keep the shape. I mean, it's not time to throw the centre-half and the goalkeeper forward yet, but we're approaching that moment.
Goal news from Juventus.
It's a third goal for Juventus. It's been scored by Paul Pogba.
That's a foul. It's going to be a free kick here. Shot from the free kick. Good try. It was the post, though. It's a Juventus goal, if you missed that rather short report from Alan McAnally. The score is now 3-1. Badelli. It's a late free kick here. The goalkeeper, with a textbook save, and keeps the ball in his grasp. Keeping the move going. And here's the shot. I wonder whether the goalkeeper can get his head to this corner. Still trailing, but they have a corner now. A definite result, 2-1. Really bad weather today, really good game.
Yeah, we forgot about the weather only 10 minutes in, because it was so entertaining. Great stuff.
Serie A. Chievo Verona 0, Napoli 2, Frosinone 1, Torino 2, Inter 3, Udinese 0, Juventus 3, Genoa 1, Roma 2, Hellas Verona 0. So what do those results mean to the league table? At the top of the table, we have new leaders in Lazio with 12 points. In second, Bologna with 12 points. In third, AC Milan with 10 points. In fourth, Torino with 10 points. In fifth, Genoa with 9 points. In sixth, Roma with 7 points. In seventh, Inter with 7 points. In eighth, Juventus with 6 points. Bottom of the table, Perugia with 1 point. And then reading up the table, second bottom, Frosinone with 1 point. Fourth bottom, Sampdoria with 2 points.
Well, we're with the Italians today. I'm Martin Tyler. Alan Smith is with me. Serie A football for you. Milan, a good side they look at the moment. They won away their last game against Sassuolo.
It was quite close, that 2-1 victory, but they just edged through and probably do the same here.
This is the Milan lineup. Diogo Lopez starts in goal. Ignacio Abate starts with Mattia Ischilio in the fullback positions. Giacomo Bonaventura starts, looking to continue his great form in midfield.
And today, it's just the one striker in the side.
Check on Chievo for you and their team list today. The referee's got to manage this match, and giving the foul, I think, is quite a good thing to do. One side with bags of goals, the highest scoring side in the division, and the other team with the worst defence. So it should be clear-cut here, but the joy of football is it rarely pans out that way.
We might get a surprise, but, you know...
Now the shot! And he scores spectacularly!
Well, what a finish to take it on first time like that and to get the accuracy.
And that has opened the scoring. 1-0 here. Now he's looking for support. One or two tackles early on. He's given the free kick here. He's going to get his message across the ref. What a fine save! That's gone out for a goal kick. We can see it another time, Alan, this vital match-leading goal.
He's got his shot off now.
Just over the top. That is a cheap piece of play to give the ball away like that. Fabrizio Cacciatore. There goes the cross. And it's going to be a goal kick.
on EA Sports soon, presenting the Serie A fixture Chievo. They'll be hosting Sassuolo.
Well, given their respective form, I think this is going to be a good game, and big 3 points at stake.
We could be in. Shots on here.
Deflected behind. A clear corner.
Shots on! Oh, the bar's still shaking.
He's got it away. Majorini. Well, that's a good challenge between the two of them there.
Very weak challenge.
Deschilio. Kuchka.
Pass cut off. They are still one down, but it shouldn't be the case.
No, really, the keeper was exposed, and he was helped an awful lot by the lad who's missed that shot.
And it's Milan trying to attack now.
Just a heavy touch, the opposition could take the ball away. Really on top of their game now. Wonderful understanding.
Here's the shot off the post.
Brilliant technique in the tackle. Hetemai. Majorini. And the cross is in. And that will be a goal kick. Kuchka. Jeremy Menez.
Is a tackle and a half.
Hetemai.
Not what Milan were hoping for at this stage. I think that's an understatement. They haven't played with any great cohesion. Some sorting out to do at half time.
Majorini. Couldn't keep it in play. It's gone out for a throw. Attack now. Hetemai.
Very successful there, he's got possession.
Kuchka.
Well, the referee has signaled.
So we're all set for the second half.
Maurizio Cacciatore.
And shoots!
That's flown way over the top.
Bonaventura.
It could be. Hit the post.
keep possession with that header. Biersen. He's moved in trying to jostle the opponent off his stride. Laporte has been penalised here. Ignazio Abate.
Wonderful save. Had to really reach out for that.
Milan have a corner. They're behind him.
Shut off now.
Castro.
Now the shot. It's a goal.
Just widen the margin here to 2-0. Well, he's got on the score sheet, hasn't he? And now he's getting off the pitch.
That tackle has got in the ball.
Majorini. Pires. Etemai.
Cross comes in now.
Well, the goalkeeper will hope that it stays like that throughout the game.
Miranda.
The shot's on.
Going for more glory, even though they're already in the lead.
Curled that up into the top right-hand corner. Well, the keeper, he can only wave at that.
Off we go again, 2-1. Etemai. He's given it and got it back again. Pires. Football is a passing game, which it is. You think about players like him. Miranda. Possession with Milan. Just keep an eye on the clock and keep an eye on Milan's efforts to try and at least draw level in this match.
Now, too many of their top players, their best ones, have been way below par here so far.
Majorini. Etemai.
Now they've tried Milan, but it hasn't been good enough, and it doesn't seem as though it is going to be good enough to
stop the game for the free kick.
It's yellow from the ref.
Oh, without question,
keeping an eye on the time here. He still could have a decisive moment in the short time that remains. They're in a good position here. He's taken it away there with a very good tackle. Terrific tackle. It's come to an end now as the referee calls a halt. The inquest is almost starting now, so soon after the final whistle, about the reasons for this defeat.
Yeah, disappointment all round, and maybe one or two.
One side with bags of goals, the highest scoring side in the division, and the other team. Another shot! And he scores spectacularly.
Serie A. Bologna 0, Juventus 0, AC Milan 1, Chievo Verona 2. So what do those results mean to the league table? At the top of the table remain Lazio with 13 points. In second, Bologna with 13 points. In third, AC Milan with 10 points. In fourth, Torino with 10 points. In fifth, Genoa with 9 points. In sixth, Roma with 7 points. In seventh, Inter with 7 points. In eighth, Fiorentina with 7 points. Bottom of the table, Perugia with 1 point. And then reading up the table, second bottom, Frosinone with 1 point. Fourth bottom, Sampdoria with 2 points. Euro League. Saint-Étienne 4, Rosenborg 1. Dundalk 2, Real Sociedad 0. Hertha Berlin 3, Panathinaikos 2. Lech Poznan 1, AC Milan 1. Motherwell 1, Napoli 1. Sturm Graz 0, Everton 1.
Well, we're with the Italians today. I'm Martin Tyler. Alan Smith is with me. Serie A football for you. And the game today is Frosinone against Milan. This is the home team lineup. Well, it's pretty fashionable these days, isn't it? The 4-3-3 gives you the three in midfield, which managers like to have that extra solidity.
Yeah, that's right. I'm just looking at the two wide lads up top. They are more central strikers, trying to do a job. Be interested to see how they get on.
Our referee here is Gianluca Del Tarano. Kuchka. Milan are attacking now.
He's got his shot off now. He's kept it out.
Can go back to the goalkeeper here and does. Well, they're glad to have him in the lineup today, aren't they? They wouldn't want to miss out on his talents, Milan.
What I like about him is his acceleration as much as just that outright pace. He can really leave somebody flat-footed when he's got a mind to it.
Well, it was easy on the eye, but in the end, pretty easy to defend against. The tackle there is successfully done.
Menez, they've scored by the crossbar.
And that has opened the scoring. 1-0 here. Rubio. Here's a chance to attack.
Can he do it?
They're grateful for that, to have an intervention like that and get back on the ball when they're defending so much.
Shots on here.
That's perhaps as much down to the conditions, that miss, Alan, as to the player himself.
Yeah, it's a wet surface and obviously a wet ball. Your timing has got to be spot on.
Team have some work to do because they've lost their last two games. They've got home advantage. He wants to play on the shoulder of the last defender. He's just got to get it right. It's all about timing. They tried to keep it, but they haven't been able to do that. Now they've got a chance in this part of the pitch. It's a strong tackle right by the touchline. It's put the ball out for a throw. The chance came to him on his weaker side. That explains it, really.
It does, and you really think he should be better on that side. He's a professional footballer. He should be practicing in training.
Kuchka. Clever little back heel. Again, possession squandered, really. We'll go back to the goalkeeper here. Can't blame him for that. Decision is a throw. It was a fair tackle. Again.